develop those two mad head dumb teachers UE5 hands.
So, don't smoke, kids. In this lesson, and this is a short little tutorial. See this cube? We're gonna make it buoyant. So, boop. I just said bounce, because I put it way too high up in the air. But it's floating, and that's the important bit. So how we do that is, I'm in game BP. I had made a folder called Random Crap, because that's where you store all random crap. And then I made this actor called Floating Object. So I'm going to double-click on that. Right now, all I'm going to do... You know what? I'll start from scratch. Okay. So... Object... I'm making an actor. I'll just call it... Melon. What? Fuck you. So, what we need to do is add a static mesh. We can decide it whatever we want. I am going to go with... You know what? I'll do first person projectile. Where is it? That thing's ridiculously... Oh, it's big. How big is this? How big is it? Wow, that's actually kind of huge. I'm gonna stick with that. Want to scale it down? No. So we need to actually simulate physics on this thing. But more importantly, from what I've seen, I haven't done much experimentation with this yet. The static mesh has to be the root component, so make sure your thing is at 000. Uh-huh. And then you have to make it the root component. How do we do that? Drag it and put it up here. So it's now the root component. As you can see, we can't move this thing because because the default scene route allows you to move things. But since this is a default scene route, can't move it. Nope. All you can do is screw with its scaling. So we're gonna have to simulate physics now. Simulate physics. Make sure that's ticked. Then we're going to add buoyancy. Because the last time I didn't know how to spell buoyancy. I usually had to Google it. So, buoyancy, let's go here. I said here. So buoyancy relies on points. This is a point-based system. I'm going to go back into the floating object. Scroll up here. You see these arrows are just here for reference only. I just needed to know the location of the... So how buoyancy works is you need to have... location data of the specific vertex, vertices that you want it to float, that you want this thing to be buoyant at. With this cube, I chose, undo that move. I chose these for basically the edges, and then I got the location data of the vertices from the arrow location. So, how do we do that here? Well, with this sphere. Let's just say I want like 2 points. I'm going to add an arrow component. I'm going to drag this out. I want... let's do it here. Is there any way you can be precise? If you take this sphere into any 3D modeling program and find the exact vertex location, I'll turn off snapping. I think this is a snap. Yep. So. And now I'm gonna duplicate this. By hitting Control D. Control D's nuts. And then I'll do this here. There's a looking on that side. Okay, so it needs to be a little more out. So I need these three bits of data from both arrows. How do I do that? So in order to add points, you see where it says pointers, zero elements? You need to add two. So one, two. And then in here, what we can do is we get the location data of both of the arrows. So here, I'm just gonna get that, copy it over, and then paste it in to here for the actual data. Otherwise, you could leave it at 000.
Really?
Yeah.
Wait, we can leave it at 000?
Yes.
Okay, what will that do?
So, here's how the buoyancy pointers work. If we're at 000, right? Then it'll go at the bottom of this mesh. It'll be pulling a Jesus and just be walking on water. But with the buoyancy points, we want to say, okay, what's the point that you want this thing to float? So with this hard attachment points here and here, so it'll just be like, oh, okay, so this is where you want it to float. So it'll just float based on those two points.
Is there a way you can, like, just...
Just what?
Can you add more points?
Oh, yeah. You can add as many points as you want. Keep in mind, you are not restricted to you're not restricted to any points. Like, you can have as many points as you want. I'm just doing two. And in the cube, I just did four. Come on, let's move this out here. Let's simulate. I think it's rolling, isn't it?
Why is that?
Keep in mind the mass of the object if the thing's too fucking big. I'll put more points. And I'll just leave them in 000. You know, I think I'll I can't scale this down because it's the root component, that's right. Shit. Let's try now.
That's sinking again.
Well, at least this one isn't.
Is it really because of the size of the shape?
Yes, it can't. Yes. Because, when I scaled this up...
Like, I'll scale it up now.
Like that.
Okay.
This thing's just gonna hit the ground hard.
Oh shit.
Yeah. So I put this at 111 again. Simulate.
Huh.
Yeah.
I mean, you could put more points. Are you gonna try to, like, you know, screw with this?
No.
I mean, I don't wanna put the high priority on this, but fine. I mean, like,
I don't control these nuts. But I'm pretty sure it's not gonna work. Or rather, it will work, it's just that this thing's too fat. Let's go here. Get the location data. Oh God. Let's go to the other arrow.
Why don't you copy the Z-axis?
What do you mean? It's the same for all 4 points.
Oh.
It's not gonna work. If it does, then I'll be surprised. Fall to the ground, yes.
So, wait, can we scale it?
It probably won't work, but I'm gonna try. Yes, flop dead to.
Oh! Okay. So it won't work on fat objects.
Like I said, I didn't do much experimentation. I'm gonna try working with fatter objects.
Why isn't it, like, floating? Or rather, what the hell's going on?
Well, it's... I mean, we did put, like, 4 points on a small thing.
Why is this one acting more lifelike than the sphere?
Because the sphere, like I said, the sphere is super fat. This is tiny. We'll work more with the, I will do some more experimentation in terms of like what you can really get away with.
Like what? Are we gonna do boats?
Maybe. Because boats involve pawns being... Because the only way I could see a boat working if you put a buoyancy component on it is when you're, you know, hitting the WASD keys, you have to have... It's like the hovercraft tutorial that I did a while back when I was cloning the land speeder for the Space Marine land speeder.
How do you figure?
You just have to have a ridiculously huge number to get that thing moving.
Oh.
Yeah. Ugh. Plus, we need to make sure that this thing... other than that, there's really nothing else I can show. Someone did your narrator.
There you have it! Wait, what are you gonna do next week?
Well, we'll have more fun with water stuffs before we start modeling the town. I gotta admit, though, I was not expecting the water to be so... damn good looking. Anyway, let's end it here.
And there you have it, game developers. Tune in next week for Matt Dumb Teaches UE5 Years.